Hey guys, this is me, Visa. Welcome back to another video on my channel. So today we have an Bose QC2, which is popularly known as Y Comfort 2. So which is a directly competitor for the Sony WC-MX1000. So they both have pretty quite similar qualities like active noise cancellation, adaptive noise cancellation, and it can also be used as a two-way communication while you are in some metro or bus or you are traveling somewhere and you have some pretty loud noises around you. Then you can use those noise cancellation till there will be 3 levels or 4 levels according to a brand. For Sony it will be around 6 to 7 levels, and for Bose there are around 3 levels. So after unboxing, I'm going to talk much more in detail regarding the QC35 2. So let's unbox this. Actually it was unwrapped beforehand because I had to get some more knowledge about the QC35. So I have tested it before showing you guys. So this product was unboxed freehand beforehand. So I'm just going to remove the upper slide. So the welcome letter shows Bose. Then after opening it, you will be getting an app and how it is going to work and in what platforms it is available. So it is also available for iOS devices and Android devices. This is a hard shell case, a QC35 2, inside the box, and this is pretty comfortable and you can use it on the daily basis. While you are traveling somewhere, you can just put your QC35 2 into a box because it has got some pretty hard case. Put your tickets or your bus tickets, but you can put your mobile phone. It got an elastic luggage pocket, you can call it as. You can just put your wires like the charging port or the aux port, that is preferable. And you got an carry cord here through which you can just wristband which can be used to tie this up, and you can hold it onto your hand. I mean, you can carry with your hand. Putting it aside, in box there is not much content available. There is only and 7 languages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So there are 16 language setup menu card, you can say it as. So if you are from different origins across the globe, then you can just quickly go through them and you can know much about the product. And I guess this is the manual, but again this will be also coming with the 16 different languages. So I don't think I'm going to go through all of them for you right now because this video might go very big. If you have not seen my last video of the Zook Thunder Rocker, there will be a link in the I button over there which is being popped out. You can go over there, you can check out the speaker. This is a wonderful one. And as it was going on Amazon and Gradient sale, there are so many shipments going to come up and we are going to catch up many more videos. I'm going to catch you guys up in next few videos with some cool stuff. So if you don't want to miss my updates, then click the subscribe button and click the notification button and change the notification to all the notifications so that you will be getting notification whenever I'm going to upload a video. Okay, I forgot to mention something. I guess this product is extensively for the Apple users because there are many such logos you get made for iPhone, made for iPad, made for iPod, and it also supports the Google Assistant for Android users and also the Siri. You can control your device, call it as OK Google or Hey Alexa, and quickly your product is going to respond to you. And talking regarding the case, I don't know how hard it is going to be, like how much impact it is going to take, because it is a pretty thick layer of the hard case over here right now. Okay, so here we go. This is how the pre-packed, actually I packed it back, so maybe some things might be over here and there, so don't mind, never mind. Okay, I'm directly removing it. So you will be getting 2 foam sheets to support the hard foam, and type C cable to charge up your device very quickly. You can connect it to your power bank, your laptop, or and also you will be getting an aux cable which is very extensive for Bose. It is not only for Bose QC, I mean Quiet Comfort 35 2, but almost all every Bose product comes with an unique aux. speakers with the aux, but the aux cables, this is a regular 3.5mm headphone jack which will be compatible with all the devices. But on the other end, this is, I guess, 2.5mm connector which is only extensive for Bose products, and you will not be getting the same on all the devices. For Sony it will be 3.5mm to 3.5mm, and for Bose almost all every product like QC1, QC2 and other all will be getting the almost all same wire, aux wire you can call it as, but the thickness of the cable is brought down drastically across the products. So I'll be showing you in a while. So I got this is almost all same build quality like Bose regular typical headset, and you'll be getting a power button over here. You'll be getting a pretty decent green button. So as I said earlier, the talking regarding the cables, this is the QC25, which is an older product. It's released 3 or 4 years earlier, and you can see how drastically the thickness of the cable has been brought down. This is quite comparatively very thin, and this is very thick, and almost, you can see the at the two sides it is 2.5mm jack or an adapter jack, and on the other hand it is a typical 3.5mm headphone jack. Nowadays almost all the flagship mobiles are missing the headphone jack, and they are getting type C cable or lightning cable, or depending upon the company they are giving some other cables. And I guess this is the main reason behind removing all those typical 3.5mm headphone jacks, are because they have to decrease the thickness of the mobile, and they have to enhance the battery capacity. If you're going to just put a single type C charging shell or whatever you call, it is quite comfortable for everyone. But for gamers or for persons who will be using the type 3.5mm headphone jack adapter, or else using the old versions like the QC25 headset, then they have to get an adapter for it. Okay, talking regarding the build quality, it is very similar to all the Bose old products, and it has got some matte finish, but still you can see there is some little reflection on the product. Maybe it is because of the light which is facing directly towards me. And the cushioning almost all it's same. So presently it is very quiet. The active noise cancellation is working all right. And for connecting the Bose QC35 to your smartphone, you need an application called Bose Connect, which is very handy. I've just gone through a product. I guess I was talking too loud because I was not able to hear how much my voice is coming out of my mouth. And talking regarding the headset, this is the left one and this is the right side. On the left and right side, you'll be getting the buttons behind the headset, such that you will not be able to see any physical buttons while you're talking to someone. And this looks quite comfortable, but sometimes very creepy because you have to always put your hand behind the ears to get towards the buttons. So whenever you're going to put the noise cancellation to off, I can hear my own voice directly from the headset because it has got a two-way mic. I mean, you can just communicate with the other fellows around you, and it is taking the input, or else it is taking my own input from my own voice. And when you're keeping it at the low, it is cancelling noise to an extent level, not up to the 100%, so maybe around 35% or 45%. And when you're keeping it for the high, so the noise cancellation has been increased from 35-40 to 80%, I guess. I'm not sure because there is no percentage, there is only high, low and off. And there's another cool feature, I don't know it is available with the Sony or not. You can connect two Bose Quiet Comfort at a time, and you can share your music with them. So this is the app has not yet configured to my own personal settings, so I will show you up later if possible. And you can see how many devices your Bose has been connected. Plus you can just turn it off and it will be disconnected. And if you want to connect to it automatically, then you can just tap the button and it has got connected. This is how the application is working. And talking regarding the Sony, it has got headphone connect app. Going into a setting session, you will be getting, let me remove it. right now I'm able to hear my own voice. It's like I have been on an aeroplane for around 12 to 18 hours, and now my ears are blessed with the signature sound, I mean the room sound, the ambient sound, so whatever you want to call it. The same app to connect to the different Bose products like QC2, Bose Revolve or Bose Connect, and n number of devices, and almost all be using the same application over here. On the other hand, you'll be getting an active button to whatever you want to activate, like Alexa or noise cancelling. Just click, there is a button on over here, so clicking that, your assistant will be waking up and letting you help to call your friends or your to go through your calendar or go through your to-do list and etc etc. And from here you can control your device completely, like you can, if there is any firmware update, you can update it from the device itself. You can connect to other Bose QC2 and you can share music with them. There is an option and noise cancellation action button, which is used to activate or wake your assistant or wake your noise cancellation and reducing it either to low, high or off. I would recommend Bose QC2 if you're using it for your laptop for the mobile purpose, because the headphone jack, which is available, the 3.5 mm, it is being banished on the present flagship mobiles because they are getting Type-C adapters, and you can just connect it. And another thing is that the QC2 doesn't get an NFC connection, so you cannot just tap the device and you cannot directly connect to the device. You have to go to the Bluetooth settings, go to the search option and refresh that, then you will be getting an option or a pop out the Bose QC2, then you have to click it and check the prompt, then okay, done, then it will be getting connected. For other products, there is an NFC connection, so Bose is quite good. The products are quite impressive because of the product build quality or the sound it gives, the sound output it gives, but it misses out some unique features which are out there in the market. So I guess Bose might be introducing one or two other products like the headphones or something else. Options like NFC and more battery power, and I forgot to tell you, it will be taking 2 to 3 hours to completely charge up from 0 to 100, and after one cycle of charge, like 0 to 100 completion. So according to the company, I have not yet done the 0 to 100 test. So according to what Bose's claim, so they are promising and 20 hours playback time. So I don't know how many hours it is going to last for me. It's got only 4 physical buttons on the headset, as I said earlier. They will be behind your ear when you are going to wear, like such. So you will be always going your behind to click the buttons and such, right? QC35 2. So I don't know why 2 has come, because maybe there was another product in between, or else it was a generation upgrade for the Bose QC35. Okay guys, that's it about the product Bose QC35. If you like the video, the like button and share with your friends. So if you are interested, you can just, I'll be putting those links in the description, you can just go to the website and check out, and hit the subscribe button. It will be helping me a lot to bring you guys more videos about the product and tech reviews. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care, stay home, stay safe.